Transportation agencies are using a new approach to analyze safety investments. It helps them find and treat the best locations for improvement to make the roads safer.
One of the challenges we've had, and I think even what the residents that we serve have been asking for, is can we be more proactive? Can we do something before something happens?
This new approach is called data-driven safety analysis. Data-driven safety analysis is the application of the latest generation of tools for analyzing crash and roadway data. State, local, and tribal agencies are using these tools to make more informed decisions. This lets them better target highway safety investments and reduce severe crashes on their roadways. The process starts by screening a roadway network using predictive and systemic analysis to identify the sites with the highest potential for safety improvement.
Network screening is a really valuable tool for that because it's going to give you this ranked list. Having that prioritized list helps to see, hey, should we really be spending our money here at this time?
Once sites are identified for potential improvement, agencies can use the tools to understand and diagnose conditions correctly.
We're using that data to identify the intersections with the highest crashes, and then we're using data out in the field to collect more information with a human factor expert to help us to identify what behaviors, what environmental factors, what infrastructure is contributing to those crashes, and how can we mitigate those? How can we resolve those?
With this additional information, agencies can then choose countermeasures that truly address the situation.
I think all too often we like to apply known countermeasures, something that we've tried before. And I think being able to use data gets us asking the right questions and then being able to more closely follow and focus on what countermeasure we want.
You're able to hone in and into a location or a quarter segment and say, this is the contributing factor that's causing crashes along this corridor, and then be able to develop solutions or countermeasures that can directly address what has occurred.
Projects can then be prioritized and investments made with confidence based on the data.
I think one of the biggest benefits of the data-driven analysis is to have concrete evidence behind our approach, and having the actual data will support the prioritization and the project selection.
Data-driven tools can also be used to evaluate the long-term effectiveness of investments.
One of the other key pieces that we're trying to do is using data to review those solutions to see if they're making a difference.
We do the countermeasure. If we do enough of them, we're able to then analyze as a system, are those working?
Data-driven safety analysis can give agencies more confidence in their safety investment decisions.
Once you understand that big picture, you can understand where you need to start targeting your money and your projects and your programs. Without data, without the DDSA process, we wouldn't know that.
Certainly, we're using crash data and the information associated with the crashes, but we're not chasing crashes anymore. But the idea is to prevent one from happening to begin with, and we're not going to end fatalities or serious injuries if we keep waiting for something to happen.